Yo, Sports Gaming Universe, what is going on? This is Popular Stranger, and welcome to sunny Orlando, Florida, home of the Capital One Bowl, where we are wrapping up our very first season in the NCAA Football 14 Northwestern Dynasty. And coming into this game, we have a record of 10-2, the same as our opponent, who happens to be Johnny Football, Johnny Manziel, and Texas A&M. And we're going to start things off by taking the ball, winning the coin toss, and moving right up the field as Mike Trumpy is found on a wheel route over there to the right-hand side. A lot of seniors on offense today, including Kane Coulter, who finds Pierre Youngblood over the middle right there for a first down. And then he's going to scramble to his left, get over up into about the 15-yard line. Kane Coulter, a big part of this offense in his last season as a senior. And he had some disappointing games, some bad interceptions that he's thrown. Look at Trayvon Green with the juke move, and he gets in for the touchdown, a 17-yard run to take a 7-0 lead. So Kane Coulter's a senior. Mike Trumpy's a senior. These guys want to get a win. Some heartbreaking losses early in the season, as I said, that we are 10-2 coming into this game right now. Very first loss of the year was against number one Ohio State, who happens to be playing in the national championship against Texas. And I won't spoil those results, but if you want to check out more on this series, check out the very first season. Check out season number two, which is coming on up. Make sure you check out the link down below in the description that gets you over to my channel. As you see, Texas A&M just getting right up the field. They were ranked number one in the nation in offensive points per game and yards. And I knew that it would be a tough task to stop Johnny Football and the rest of the crew. As you see, Mike Evans is going to get a touchdown to even up the score 7-7. But we had a heartbreaking loss to Ohio State. We had a chance to win the game inside the five-yard line, down 3 points with about 20 seconds left. Two timeouts, so we had a chance to take a couple shots at the end zone before we could settle for overtime. And as I mentioned, Kane Coulter just made a horrible decision. I made a horrible decision throwing the ball, and we threw an interception in the end zone to blow that game. We got back on track with a bunch of Big Ten wins in a row against Nebraska, against Michigan, and then we matched up against Michigan State, who at the time was unranked. And they beat us. They beat us in the fourth quarter. A couple more Kane Coulter interceptions would ultimately decide the fate of that game and knocked us out of our chances of getting into a BCS bowl. But here we are taking a 14-7 lead over Texas A&M, who again has the same record as 10-2 as they lost to Alabama in the SEC. And I'm sorry, I didn't write down their second loss. But they still had a pretty good season. So now one of these teams has to go home with their third loss, and the other team is probably going to finish up inside of the top 10. Which one will it be? As you see, they're going to get across to the 50. I started playing the pass heavy after that first drive, and then all of a sudden they just switched it up on me and started running the ball here as they get up to about the 30-yard line, tackled out of bounds. Another run to Williams, who's going to truck one of my players, break another tackle, and get inside the 30, and then they're going to go back and look for the pass out of bounds. We hold them down to 4th and 11, and they're going to kick a field goal to trim that lead, but now we're still up. And right before halftime, kind of making a push to try to get some points before the half. Kane Coulter's going to scramble again to his left, get to midfield, drop back, looking for, it looked like, Jones. And they're going to intercept the ball right before halftime. There's another bad decision. Kane was playing so well. I was playing so well. Too many turnovers this year that I've done, and that's kind of where we're at with all the losses, or the two losses. Definitely had a chance to run the table, but just I've been making some bad decisions, and Johnny Manziel's going to get rocked right there to cut it to 3rd and 5. Good job by the defense responding after we throw the interception. They'll let them score, allow them to get the ball back after halftime. We do force them to a punt, only down 3 now, and Jones is going to return this punt over to about the 50-yard line, a little across the 50, and we're in good field position now to try to score. Kane Coulter with a option there, keeps the ball, goes to the left across the 50-yard line, and then Mike Trumpy, the senior, picks up the first down, rushes over for 100 yards. That was team-wide, though, not for just him. Little play action right there. Kyle Prater found over the middle for another first down. Trayvon Green goes into motion. And this time we're going to find Pierre Youngblood, the slot receiver, with a nice juke move. And he's going to score 6 right there. Put up the dynasty sign as we take the lead again over Texas A&M. So now we find ourselves in the third quarter with about 3 minutes to go and the lead, trying to protect it against this high-powered offense and this good quarterback. And they're going to continue to run the ball out of the shotgun, which is a really tough thing to defend, because if you're expecting pass and they're always coming out in shotgun, you're going to play that pass offense and you get burned up the middle. Then when you go after the run, they get you back with a pass to the slot receiver on a streak. And they're going to take the lead again, 24-21, as we're still in the third quarter, driving down the field. The option fakes to Trumpy. Coulter keeps it at the last minute. I tried to pitch it to Trayvon Green. It ended up being a fumble. Luckily, we're able to recover the ball and keep the ball as Kyle Prater is going to be found there for an 18-yard pass to get another first down. And we're going to try the option thing out. Kane Coulter keeps the ball again. This time he pitches to Kyle Prater, who gets smacked but still gets a decent gain. Coulter drops back, finds Pierre Youngblood again to get inside the 5-yard line. Coulter dropped back once more, finds Christian Jones this time over the middle. Not enough for a touchdown, but Trayvon Green will find the end zone for the second time this game on a 3-yard TD run, and we reclaim the lead once again, a back-and-forth game. This time it's 28-24. Manziel once again hands off here into the fourth quarter now with about 5 minutes left. Manziel with the play action. He's looking. He finds Mike Evans. He once again gets up to the 40-yard line, and they're just moving down the field now. We're hoping that we can get a stop. A nice tackle there to cause a 4-yard loss. Manziel drops back looking for the screenplay. It's not there. We're all over it. A 6-yard loss and force them to punt the ball. We're going to run a screen of our own this time to Trayvon Green as he's going to make a move and get up to the 25-yard line. And now, right now, with the lead, 3 minutes to go, we're just trying to kill the clock. Trayvon Green, who will be the starting running back in next year's season, just makes a nice move, and then Mike Trumpy runs somebody over to get across the 50-yard line. Trayvon again with a run to the left, bounces off a tackle and gets up for an 8-yard run. This time Kane Coulter's going to keep the ball, get in on the action, and we're going to play it safe and slide for the first down there, not risking any fumbles. Mike Trumpy gets up here with a 8-yard run, and then we're going to pass the ball, try to mix it up on him. Trayvon gets up to about the 11-yard line. The game was pretty much over. We could have kneeled on the ball, but Mike Trumpy's a senior. It's his last collegiate game. Let's get him a touchdown. He gets in the end zone, and that would seal the deal. 35-24, 20 seconds left. Johnny Manziel's going to have a desperation heave, but we'll end up intercepting the ball here. So a very successful first season, 11-2 overall, with a pretty big win in the Capital One Bowl. So stay tuned for the next season. If you guys like what you saw and you're ready for more, make sure you subscribe to my channel. And make sure you click a thumbs up on this video here. It really helps out Sports Gaming Universe continue to grow and grow. And I appreciate all you guys who watch my videos on here. I really do. I always get tremendous feedback when I put videos on here, and tons of subscribers heading over to my channel. So make sure you do the same. Make sure you visit my channel. Check out all my other videos, NCAA, Madden-wise, and other sports gamings as well. It's Popular Stranger. I'm out. Peace.